Anybody who tries to tell you exactly who she was, they didn't know her at all.
I remember watching Gia, the 1998 Angelina Jolie movie with my mum one evening, and blushing and cringing and wanting to hide behind a cushion at Jolie and Elizabeth Mitchell's blatant lust for each other. No one enjoys watching sex scenes with their parents, but this was the first time I'd seen two women so in love and so unapologetic. My British LGBTQ plus high school education was relegated to that Tattoo music video in 2002. Britney and Madonna's Kiss in 2003. And I vaguely remember the outcry of Brokeback Mountain in 2005, which as a pansexual teenage female, I wasn't especially the movie's demographic. Television came to my rescue as I was given the box set of The L Word for a birthday by other members of my questioning friend group. Yet hiding the DVDs in my bedroom didn't give me the representation that I craved. I wanted to walk down the streets, look up at the cinema's feature films, and feel included. Over in the US, where the majority of blockbuster films are created, the GLAAD Studio Responsibility Index maps the quantity, quality, and diversity of lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer characters in films released by the seven major motion picture studios, the ones we're all so familiar with.
The thing I am most proud of is the moment when someone comes up to me on the street and says, "I came out because of you." That is the tangible, immediate power of LGBTQ visibility.
In 2018, of the 110 releases from the seven largest Hollywood studios, 20 included LGBTQ plus characters.
So you're gay?
Totally, yes.
My name is Monica, and I'm a queer artist. Since the first commercial cinema opened in Paris in 1895, going to the movies has been an outing enjoyed by families, couples, and friends, with a variety of specifically chosen, moderated genres available. We are all familiar with the archetypal movie genre categories that are hailed at each award ceremony. Action, adventure, science fiction, fantasy, romantic movies, romantic comedies, comedies, crime, thrillers. The list continues to eventually include LGBTQ plus films. The first time two women kissed on the silver screen was back in 1930, when Marlene Dietrich's character Amy Jolly in Morocco playfully kisses another woman on the lips during a musical number. Though hardly a coming out scene, it was considered scandalous for the time. Unfortunately, due to censorship and the conservative codes that swept the American film industry by storm, the 20th century saw relatively few queer characters, unless they were fulfilling stereotypes or received their apparently necessary comeuppance for flouting morality. Though these first codes did not explicitly target homosexuality, it was implicitly included under the phrase sexual perversion.
It looks so different from the outside.
No, hey, Mom.
The attitude towards homosexuality has changed in the last few decades. The 21st century has provided much more queer representation than in the past, overcoming stereotypes and tropes, though the genres have tended to stay in the comfortable romantic corner with a few comedic nuances.
You're a
International and independent films have fared similarly, though we are sorely lacking an out-and-proud superhero in mainstream cinema, or indeed in any large blockbuster franchise. My intention for Lavender Girls is to focus purely on lesbian female relationships and their portrayal from an international perspective. Rather than a comparison or a focus on the romantic aspect, I am more interested in how each queer individual divulges their sexuality to their peers. How do these different characters come out? How long into these explicitly lesbian films does it take for the words to be said?
No. Maybe now the laws have changed.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm gay.
How old were you when you came out?
Young.
Oh, that's nice.
I have a girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, that's nice too. Though it's not the same thing.
Haven't you shamed us enough already?
It's the first time in my life I look like this at a woman.
That deserves a kiss.
I'll see you in a couple years.
How often is the sexuality inferred through prolonged eye contact, hand-holding, or without ever having to hear the words, I'm gay, I'm a lesbian, I love a woman? These blurred paintings are my interpretation of the coming out freeze frame.
I hope to settle with a female companion.
It started when I broke up with my girlfriend.
Whether she is saying it to her friends.
You're coming out of the closet.
Are you coming out of the closet?
You're gay. Freddy, you gay?
Her family.
Listen to me, I'm gay!
Her girlfriend.
Would you leave to live with me? This is real, Natasha, not a fantasy.
Or if she is outed by other characters. That specific moment of self-acceptance, where your truth is more important than other people's feelings and expectations. Many LGBTQ plus films embody and share various coming out stories, and each one is different, and each one is valid.
Everybody's story is different. There's your version, and my version, and everything in between. But the one thing that all of those stories have in common is that moment right before you say those words, when your heart is racing and you don't know what's coming next.
Is their sexuality acknowledged? Is their sexuality accepted?
I can do this!
Are they included with a well-written backstory? Or does being gay become their personality? For those of us whose sexuality has been considered taboo, a chronic lack of education coerced us into a cinematic corner where we learned more than just slang. We saw ourselves on screen, and suddenly we were no longer alone in our corner, and our community and confidence grew. I've already mentioned the profound impact that Gia had on my sexual awakening. And I deplore the fact that I'm going to say the following sentences. Gia did not make me gay. I was already gay. But Gia helped me feel accepted, understood, and no longer alone. Lavender Girls is about that realization. But not about any one specific story. It's about all of our stories, however long it takes us, if we've known since childhood or discovered it in our golden years. By focusing on the most explicit moment of coming out in these films and gaining a timestamp,
I hope to settle with a female companion.
I'm able to highlight these journeys, recognizing and celebrating how exceptional it is for everyone. By discovering how long each film takes to get to that moment, it's so satisfying to hear the words that can take some people a lifetime to say. Lavender Girl's coming out has given me the opportunity to revel in my own sexuality. But more than that, I have learned, shared, discovered, and cried over the stories that have not been told often enough. Every coming out story is different, and everyone deserves to be loved for living their truth. We need more lesbian representation in cinema, directed by queer women, telling powerful stories that will consistently speak to the sapphic goddess inside each of us. Lavender Girls is a celebration of our visibility, of recognizing that terrifying yet wonderful moment of self-realization on a journey towards eventual self-acceptance.